What's up, everybody? Peepo here, and today is going to be a pretty nice little review about the Thompson i6. Now, before we get started, I did have it on this wood shaft from Fitz. It is zebra wood, and it is pretty hard, so I'm probably going to leave it on it for a little bit longer, but I definitely want to be able to use this. I'll get into that in a second, but the Thompson i6, the very first modern head created by, I believe, the Iroquois Nations. I could be wrong about that, but it is the first one created by the Thompson Lacrosse Company, and it has the Six Nations flag design going into the side. And I decided to get a purple one because, I mean, what am I going to do with a white one? It's just going to get dirty, and it's going to get dirty. It's not going to be white any longer. If you just get a purple plastic one, it's going to stay purple for pretty much ever. And plus, one of the Six Nation colors, so I've decided to go with purple instead of trying to decide on what to do with a dyed head when that could fade over time. But so initially I had thought to get this as to use, and then I realized it's a pinnacle moment for lacrosse, especially for the Native Americans and the tribes and everything like that. And it's just, to me, I'm very big on the history of lacrosse, so this is definitely just a thing of significance to me in the history of the sport that I love. And so I decided to get the head, not just to use for a little bit, but to put on my wall. It's going to go up on the wall. And I'll probably get another one to actually use, maybe get it dyed or something like that. But this one is going to be real special to me. It's going to go on the wall. It's going to be for display purposes only. And so let's just get into it. So first off, with aesthetics, it is very, very clean. You can just see how smooth and everything this thing looks. It's very, very simple throat design. Just open holes in the side. These three little holes in the front. You can, if you really want to, you can shove leathers through there or strings, but I really wouldn't recommend it, especially if you don't want the leathers to be like frayed or destroyed or anything. It's just a little too tight for the front. Plenty of room in the back here. You can probably see right through there. You can see my finger through there. That's definitely big enough to go through with the leather and come back out and wrap around in the back, so that the leathers are out of your way when you're cradling and shooting and stuff. But so, very, very nice aesthetically. The Thompson, hopefully you can see that. Thompson right here, very clean. There's no X-spec or anything like that designations, but it is universal. It is being able to be used for high school and college. And box, from my understanding, they are actually making a box version, just strictly box. So you guys that are pinching your Thompson i6 is for box, just stop, don't do it. They're going to be actually having a box style head. It's going to be the i6, same design, just pinched and designed for box specifically. So getting back into it, I mentioned earlier that the Six Nations, the Six Nations flag emblem is actually the sidewall design. It has the ridges and everything, has the very center. Each of the nations for the Iroquois going through this. I'm just really glad that they were able to do this. Very clean, no extra stuff. It stands on its own to what it is. And just very clean. You can get real close and actually see the detail of which this is actually involved in. And it's just overall just awesome that you're able to put this into a sidewall design. Usually you just see struts or flames or something, just like, okay, that's cool, put that in the sidewall. And then you get this and it just blows your mind. I don't really think it's going to break too much here. It's very sturdy plastic. There's no super, super, super thin struts or anything like that. So I don't really see it breaking too easily in the sidewall or cracking or anything. So it should be okay. Get up into the scoop. It has a very well-designed, protected top hole design. for 6 holes, pretty much do anything that you want stringing wise with it. And that just real flat, real not super aggressive scoop. And you don't really need a super aggressive scoop to get a good pocket in it. And most people think otherwise, but I beg to differ. But with the design of the scoop, it protects the string, the leathers, whatever you're going to put up there. It's going to protect it pretty well. And so they're very well spaced too. When I had mesh in it, I didn't really have to pull super hard to get the mesh into the spot that I needed it to be. Very good spacing. They did their homework on that. So kudos to Thompson Lacrosse for that. And then we get into the sidewall holes. Sidewall holes are pretty nice. It's got one circular hole at the top for if you're going to do traditionals. And I mean, it's the natives. They're going to want to do traditional in it. And a lot of people just want a good head for traditional. And this one has pretty much set a good bar for that. But so it has a circular one on both sides for just a single string, or if you really want to try, shove two strings in. And then from then on, all the sidewall holes are rectangular in nature. So you can pretty much fit 2 strings in every single sidewall hole from then on. You can squeeze a third in there if you harden the tip of the string, but pretty much everything is going to be able to use a 2. And there's a decent abundance of holes. It's not like, I want to say, a burn or anything like that. It doesn't have just an abundance like that, but it has a decent amount to where you're going to be able to get the right spacing, definitely good positioning for your knots, and you're going to be able to get a decent pocket, even though it is a generally wide head. You get into the bottom of the sidewall holes. You can't really see it because I have strings in the way, but there are these 2 bottom strings right here, this yellow one and this white one right here. They actually are 2 round holes, so it helps out a lot more with traditionals, whatever you're going to do, and very good positioning. It's going to be able to help out a lot with stringing. Going to give you a lot of variety and everything like that. The bottom holes, very well spaced for traditionals, very well sized for leathers. I didn't really have to use any tools or anything like that to get the leathers through there. Just put them in, pulled them through, good to go. And then you get into your actual screw holes, and the screw holes are actually a little big, so you don't really bite into the plastic with your screws. It's all shaft, and it just hugs, and it's got 2, so it's going to definitely be able to hold tight to it. Now, the reason why I strung it up like this is because it's going to be on display. I strung it up flat. I did leave string, and I did a storage knots on each of the strings, and then I braided everything, and it's just going to be on the wall. It's going to be for display. I don't really want to tarnish it too much, and it's just real nice. I went with nice yellow gold or golden yellow sidewalls that I did kind of like the Rocket Pocket to store more string, but also just to look good. Then yellow leathers, white cross lace or gut if you're that type of person, and then gray / silver shooting nylon that's doubled up old school style, and then I have just regular weaved black shooting laces. And all in all, it just strung up real nice. I've strung a couple of different meshes. I strung an actual traditional pocket into it just to make sure it would work. And it does. It strings everything up. And I just can't really say anything too bad until I get to this. Now, we all know that universally it's supposed to be 3 inches and then 6.5, 7 inches up top. But the thing is, I'm able to do that. One-handed, being able to almost make this part right here touch. I mean, it's not going to really be a problem. I wouldn't recommend it from defenders, so don't put it on your D-pole. It's not going to be very good for you. It's going to warp real easy. But if you're one of those guys that wants a flexi head to really get that hard shot, this is a good head for you. It's very good when it comes to stringing. Strength, obviously it's flexy, but it's strong. The thing is, like, it's not going to be able to break too easily. It's going to take a beating. So Thompson Lacrosse Company, you guys definitely did a really good job with your first ever lacrosse head, and I'm really glad that I got to get a hold of one, and I can't wait to get another one to actually use on the field, because, I mean, this is a thing in history to me, so thanks for giving me a piece of history, guys. I'll catch you later. Like, comment, subscribe, and stay tuned, because I still got some more Method Mondays, and I definitely have more reviews coming, guys. So, I'll check you later.